So, hello, welcome to this innovative course for 4D echocardiography. In this tutorial, we are going to show you how to acquire 4D images about left ventricle, right ventricle, and mitral valve and tricuspid valve. You will be able to see simultaneously how to tilt the probe, how to push the buttons on the machine, and what to expect to see on your images. So we start from the beginning. We have a patient. For a transthoracic echo, we use the 4VC probe, which is the 3D probe of GE. And we always start with parasternal views, parasternal long axis view, parasternal short axis view at the level of papillary muscles. Aortic valve. And let's start with the left ventricle. So, in order to acquire the best image for left ventricle, we should go and take a four-chamber view. This is a proper four-chamber view. And what you need to know is that in 4D echocardiography, we don't care if the apex of the left ventricle is foreshortened. The reason for that is because afterwards, we can go analyze the left ventricle, we can align our views and see the true apex. So we take a four-chamber view, and in order to increase our frame rate, we have to adjust the depth and take only the left ventricle inside. Then, on the machine, we press large, which is a full volume, and then we have this image. When you can see that we have multi-slice views of the left ventricle, and what we do next? First, we go to this images at this apical views at the left side of our screen, and we go and align this lines with the left ventricle. We do the alignment in all three views, four chamber, two chamber, and three chamber view or apical long axis, however you want to tell it. And that way we can see that in our short axis view, we have a better delineation of the endocardium. So here you can see on our screen that we have a frame rate of 19, which is nice, which is adequate for evaluation of ejection fraction, of wall motion abnormalities, and volumes of the left ventricle. We can increase or decrease the frame rate in order to have different spatial or temporal resolution. In order to increase the spatial resolution, we have to decrease the frame rate, and immediately you can see that the endocardium right now is seen much, much better than before. We can do it again, and we can choose, for example, in this view you can see that the frame rate has decreased at 6 per second. That way we don't have a nice movement of the endocardium. We have a better spatial resolution but not a good temporal resolution. What we can do to fix this image, this view, and have a very nice image of the left ventricle is to take a multi-beat acquisition of this view. In order to do that, the patient has to hold his breath for a few seconds and then push the multi-beat button and acquire the image. Above the multi-beat, you can see that we have the number of beats. Usually, we take 4 beats or 6 beats. It depends on how the patient can hold his breath. If it is a young patient, then it's easier to hold his breath and have a nice multi-beat acquisition. If he's an old patient, then it's not so easy. Of course, we have to mention that multi-beat acquisition is not feasible in patients with atrial fibrillation, because we need to stitch different cycles, cardiac cycles, and these cycles must be exactly the same. So, in this view, we can tell our patient to hold his breath. Κράτα την αναπνοή σου, χωρίς να πάρεις βαθιά. Press the multi-beat button. Αναπνέεις κανονικά. We can give some more gain to have a better imaging. And then you can see that way we have both very good spatial resolution. We can see the endocardium very well in all these 9 short axis views from apex to mitral valve. And we have a frame rate of approximately 70 frames per second. So this is a nice image. We press image store and we keep it. In this view, for example, you can see that the patient is not holding his breath. And as you can see, we have a lot of stitching artifacts. Stitching artifacts are these lines between the different cycles. For example, here we have 4 beats. So 1, 2, 3, 4 cycles that should be stitched. But we have these lines in between, which means that the patient did not hold his breath sufficiently, and we cannot, of course, interpret this image for wall motion abnormalities. If we press again the multi-beat button, we go to single beat. We can have the same result. If I increase the frame rate, now you can see that we have 19 frames per second, but the endocardium is not seen very well as before. But however, I can still press image store and acquire this image and go afterwards measure ejection fraction and volumes.